One of the results of the years of war is that the whole of Jerusalem is now under Israeli control. And Jews worship freely at the Wailing Wall. The future of the city that's holy to Jew and Muslim and Christian is one of the major obstacles to a final peace agreement. The other is the need of Palestinians to have a home of their own. In the bazaars of East Jerusalem, the Palestinian fear is clearly heard that Egypt will make peace with Israel without ensuring that the West Bank is restored to them, the Palestinians. They also fear that there'll be precious little the rest of the Arab world will do, or be able to do, to prevent a peace agreement being signed.
There is going to be a peace between them, and all signs are showing that. But it's against our Palestinian rights, because as long as we are not going to have our rights completely, it's nothing for us. Because first of all, we are not included in the treatment. Second thing, Egypt hasn't got the right to represent us even in the United States. We have our own representative, and he's Yasser Arafat.
Will this agreement, in your view, bring peace to this area?
Never. And I'm saying it. If I'm going to steal your purse or your money, you won't forgive me neither today nor after 10 days. This land is ours, and we are not going to give it up so easy. As long as we are Palestinians and we own this land, then we are going to fight for it. Neither will wait for today or for tomorrow. Somehow, some way, someday, we are going to restore it by our own efforts.
Who has stolen your purse? Who has stolen your money?
The Jews, and who are occupying us at this moment.
In Jerusalem, the hardline Israeli view is that because it's vital to Israeli security, the West Bank must be retained. In Cairo, too, a peace agreement has important opponents. The magazines on the newsstand welcome peace, but the former editor of the semi-official government newspaper Al-Ahram, Mohammed Hassanin Haykel, opposes the Sadat initiative.
To my mind, an atmosphere of peace could have been prepared with the rest of the Arab world, with the United Nations, with the two superpowers, with all the participants, with the Palestinians, who are a very important factor in this. You know, that anybody takes a step alone, it's not sufficient. I prefer, in conflicts, I think they should be solved properly and in the proper way, with all the parties, with the proper atmosphere, with the terms of reference clear in front of everybody.
Isn't President Sadat, though, determined, and in fact has said so, to link the West Bank, the Palestinian problem, with the peace agreement?
He is. He is. But, you know, on the other side, we see that Mr. Begin is determined not to link both of them. So where is the agreement? We want peace. Yes, we want peace. But, you know, it should not be peace at any price. I mean, it should be peace based on justice, be peace based on the participation of all the parties, peace dealing with all the components of the problem. That's what can make it a real peace.
But despite Haykel's fears, most Egyptians so obviously want peace that there's pressure on Sadat's government to achieve an agreement. In Cairo, there's an unreasoning optimism in the air. Whatever political obstacles stand in the way, they must be overcome.
Do you believe that because of the mood of the people, that there is actually pressure on President Sadat to keep the peace talks alive?
Yes. Yes, I'm sure of that.
Some of your Arab friends, of course, feel that there is a grave danger that the Palestinians will be forgotten when the peace agreement is signed.
Let's hope that our Arab friends, which we need very much, will appreciate this and feel what is being done. We have never wasted any of our pride. We were strong. We proved this in the battle, and we are proving it in the negotiations. If we are giving away, we could have signed a long time ago. But we are insisting on keeping their rights. This is 100% criteria in our negotiations, that the Arab rights and the Palestinian rights are there and preserved.
Jerusalem, literally, the city of peace. But the schedule for peace set 3 months ago is already overdue, and the politicians still struggle to reach an agreement. Yet at least the talks go on, and what's beyond dispute is that no one, not Israeli nor Egyptian, wants to drift back into another 30 years of war.